वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम अभिषेक अग्रवाल। वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी टुडे ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ द पेशेंट काउंसलिंग। इन दिस टॉपिक वी स्टडी अबाउट व्हाट इज पेशेंट काउंसलिंग, व्हाट इज ऑब्जेक्टिव, व्हाट इज इट्स गोल एंड व्हाट इज अबाउट द पेशेंट। सो व्हाट इज पेशेंट काउंसलिंग? द पेशेंट काउंसलिंग इज डिफाइंड एज प्रोवाइडिंग मेडिकेशन इंफॉर्मेशन ओरली एज वेल एज रिटन टू द पेशेंट एंड देयर रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑन direction of the use and advice on side effect, precaution, storage, diet and its lifestyle for the modification. Or in simple word, we can say that the patient counseling is defined as the providing medications for to how to use a drug, how to use a drug and what should be added effect of the drug to the patient and their representative. So the patient counseling is a two-way process between the patient and the doctors. Second one is it is a changing information, exchange information between the doctors and the patient, how to use the drug, how it is benefit, how it is adverse effect of the drug. Third one is it is the vital information about the medicines. Fourth one is it is a verbal or in the written form between the doctors or the pharmacist and the patient. So next one is the patient counseling, it is a individual or in a group of the patient. So it is personally as well as the telephonically. Telephonically via the telemedicine, the patient call the doctors, the doctors give a telepathy, etc. For the achievement of the therapeutic goals, it is for the beneficial for the patient. Next one is the for the design, select, implement and evaluate the therapeutic activity of the drugs. Now the objective, for the better patient understanding to their illness and what is the role of the medication to the treatment of the disease of the patient. Second one is the for the improve medication adherence to the patient. Third one is the improve the dose regimen adherence, and fourth one is the more effective drug treatment for the patient to cure the patient by the disease. Other objective is the reduce incidence of the adverse drug reaction or the adverse effect and unnecessary healthcare cost. Other one is the adverse drug reaction reporting by the patient for the improvement of the quality of the life patient, raising the image of the pharmacist and its profession. So this is all over the objective for the patient counseling. Some guidelines for the patient counseling, such as the only registered pharmacists are involved in the counseling. The facility are provided for the pharmacist and the patient. This is a confidential, and their conversion is also the confidential. The patient information leaflets are provided for the pharmacist. For proper documentation is made by the pharmacist. It's about what is the patient name, age, sex, it's was the dose to be taken by the patient, what is the drug side effect, etc. So other guidelines such as the unnecessary counseling should be avoided. In every consulting, benefit to the patient is the foremost, or it is the priority for the pharmacist, and all registered pharmacists should be engaged in the case, should be frank with the patient and his attendants, and it is most important, it is a punctually should be observed by a registered pharmacist is making themselves for the counseling of the patient. Then the some step be taken in a patient counseling. First one is the introduction of the session. Second one is the content of the session. Third one is the process flow, what is the process flow, and fourth one is the conclusion of the session. So in the introduction, we review the report of the patient from the prior to the counseling. Second one is the the pharmacist explain the purpose of the counseling session to the patient. Third one is the conduct appropriate patient counseling introduction by self and the patient to obtain a permanent drug, initial drug related information. such as the drug allergic and other medications. Next one is warn the patient about taking other medications such as the OTC drug, including the drug without prescription, herbals, botanical drugs and alcohol, which could be inhibit or interact into the prescribed medications. Then determines whether the patient and others medical condition should influence the effect of the drug, should enhance the likelihood and adverse reaction. Next one is the assess the patient understanding for the reason for the therapy, ki how to use and how much is used. Then is the content. The patient counseling should include the information who, what, where, when and how. In this content we use a who is patient, it is a male or female, what is the name of the medication, what is the name of the drug the patient taken, what is the strength and doses form of by taken by the patient, and what is the purpose of the medication taken by the patient, and how should be the medication be taken via orally, via including the duration, frequency and route of the administration taken by the patient. Other one is what to do if even dose is missed. What to do if even dose is missed? Where to store the medications? What potential of the ADR? ADR means adverse drug reaction. And what are the potential food drug interaction? These are all questions about the content. Next one content is include the what are the expected outcomes, how to monitor if treatment is ineffective or effective, what to do if unwanted outcome, what to do if unwanted outcome taking by a drugs or the medications, how to seek medical attention and how to refill there. So all these contents are involved by taken by a pharmacist, questioned by the patient. So it is a summary. First is the patient, it is confirmed the identity. Then the drug, include the name of the drug, what is strength and its doses. Second one is direction. Direction is include the route of administration, frequency, duration and storage. When the patient taking a drug, some precaution should be there. It is the adverse drug reaction and food and drug reaction. Next one is the process. This is the third one. It's a provide accurate information about the patient, the dose to be taken by the patient, about strength, frequency, status, etc. Use language such as the patient is likely to understand by the pharmacist. Use the appropriate aids to easy to understand by the pharmacist. Present the fact and order in logical order. To maintain and control the counseling session by the patient and the pharmacist, and analyze the additional information between both of them. Then verify the this is the conclusion. Verify the patient understanding via feedback, it is positive or negative. Second one is summarize the acknowledges by key point information such as drug interaction, drug doses, effect and drug allergies, etc. Other one is provide an opportunity for final concern and questions. It is open on questions between the patient and the pharmacist. Other one is help to patient to plan, follow and next consultative step for the patient counseling. Then functions of the patient counseling. It includes the better patient understanding of their illness and their role of the medication and its treatment. For improve medication adherence to treat the disease or illness of the patient, to reduce the adverse reaction and unnecessary healthcare cost, to improve the quality life of the patient, for better coping strategy, to deal with the medication related to the adverse drug effect. So next question is the patient should always be counseled. Patient who should always be counseled. It is a confused patient, illiterate patient, the patient who have a sight or hearing impaired, the patient who is poorly literacy, the patient whose profile show a change in the medication and dosing, new patient or those receiving a medication for the first time. So this type of patient we should always be counseled. Next one is the patient who should be counseled at certain intervals, such as in this include asthmatic patient, diabetic patient, the patient taking four or more prescribed drugs, the patient who are mentally ill, the patient who is an epileptic patient, and the patient with the skin diseases. These type of patient who should be counseled at a interval levels. So the communication skills by the pharmacist, it is effective counseling for the patient counseling. So communication skills is divided into two parts. First one is a verbal and second one is a non-verbal. So verbal communication is a key component of an interactive communication is using an open-ended question. Open-ended question means between the pharmacist and the patient. The open-ended question get started with the who, what, where, when, how, and why. The verbal communication include the language by the pharmacist and the patient, whether the tone is higher or lower, the volume is speed or low, and the speed of the voice. Second one is the non-verbal communication. It is in the written form, we use the body language or smiley, it include proximity, eye contact. When the eye contact is not there by the patient, it is a confused or it is a lack of confidence. And last one is the facial expression. So in the non-verbal communication, the distracting of the normal cues such as the lack of eye contact may indicate the little confidence, insufficient spatial discomfort, unfavorable tone of voice, and messy work environment. These all include in the non-verbal communication. Some barriers are there for the effective communication, such as first as the environment factor. It is the lack of privacy or furniture between the patient and the pharmacist. The environmental barrier, it's come under the physical barrier. Second one is the semantics. It is related to the meaning of the word or symbols to in interpersonal communication. Third one is the negative attitude. It is the lack of confidence in the pharmacist. The pharmacist to strive to improve their talking skills through the practice. Fourth one is the time barrier. The time are often excuse not to be counseled through it often does not vary a long time. So in the conclusion, we can say that the pharmacist being active member of the healthcare team play a important role for providing patient counseling is to improve patient compliance and the therapeutic outcome and the quality of life. Reduce the adverse effect and how to take the medicines by the patient. The patient counseling also includes the pharmacist also enables the doctor to spend more time on examination and diagnosis the patient as a counseling part is taken care by the pharmacist. So we can say that the pharmacist is a very important role for the patient counseling. Thank you.